Sweet. This piece is coming out, if you remember these pipes. That's just an extra that was holding it up. And once that's out, man. Alright, I ripped that out. All that temporary metal that once held the firewall up straight is now gone. Sheet metal's all trimmed. I decided to round these edges off. This is where the tranny line hits. I was like, you know, we're going to do it on one side, we're going to do it on both. I'll trim this all up after when we get it as part of the firewall. I mean, it's real flexible right now. We're going to put some body lines. But that 3/16 plate, I had to cut the edge because it's welded in there so good. But I ground it nice, looks good. This edge too. I'll put the plate on for you. Alright. There's a guide hole right there. And right there. Okay, like I said, this was ground to the edge. Just lightly, so I can trim it some more. The heater holes are close. I gotta move it around a little. It'll be fine. Body lines will stiffen this up. It's all rubbery right now. But this is it. Those two rails sit on top of what my floor pan starts as, is 1x1 065 wall tubing. This is actually pretty neat. What I did is, these plates are 3/16. They go top to bottom. They're one piece. I welded this to another piece right over it. So what I can do, if I put the firewall on and it's leaning too far forward or too far back when it comes to hanging the doors, nothing is welded. I can just slide it up and down, clamp it with a piece of vice grips here. There's two layers. Clamp it with a piece of vice grips when I get it where I want it. The doors are closed and latch and everything. Little tack. Tack, tack, tack. So basically my firewall leans back and forth probably a good 3/4 of an inch if you had to, but it's pretty accurate the way it is right now. It's my booster. It's my heater core. It's my heater core. I ground the face all the way around. You can see it's ripping my gloves apart. But once the body line's in, man, I'm going to reinforce this so it's not just a piece floating out, but can't do that till I trim it up. I might round this off. I don't know. I like it straight. It's about an inch away from the transmission, and you've seen that the dipstick tube for the transmission's right here. There's really nothing here, but I wanted them the same shape. I'm not worried about it. Looks good. But right up against the edge. And that scrapper piece is out here. All gone. These are just temporary scraps. Okay. Put the gas tank in the Mustang, finally. Ooh, it's gotta be 95 in here, man. I'm turning the fan back on. Oh, breath of fresh air. I'm still cracking. There'll be plenty of pictures and some more video. We're on like, Jesus, 94? 93? One little piece at a time, and I want you to see it all, you know? I don't want you to go, hey, how'd you do this? That's video 33, you know what I mean? I'm going to DA this whole thing down once I get my body lines in. I think I'm going to use quarter-inch wire and go down and then do the curve up to here just for a little support. That's it. This side will fold it over. I could also do the rivet thing out here too when I do bomber seats. I can fold a piece of aluminum over that and rivet it. You know, the heater core, I could put a rectangular piece of aluminum around it, sink it in a little, rivet it. You know, it's all about the rivets, man. And a nice little dent here. That'll come out. Gives it a little character versus just a flat piece of metal. Hope you can hear me. Well, this video is made in vain. Look there, baby. All American pies. Okay, man. We gotta do some more. Busy day. Put the gas tank back in the Mustang. It's running good, thank God. Trimmed out all that crap, as you seen earlier. Look at that, the Fiero handle doesn't bottom out anymore. Let's see if I can do it again. Loving it. I taped the firewall up, it kept falling back. I got a couple of quarter 20 bolts in here, just sitting there to hold it up. And it's no longer on the frame anymore, see? I'm still gonna trim it out, not a big deal, it's not lined up right now. But I took all my junk out of my van. I put my van on the hill and I washed that sucker inside and out. Cam bumper. Body lines be this weekend for the firewall. Tack it in, resupport it. Support it from the back, probably a quarter inch wire. I gotta get some, I don't think I have any left. I think I got one little tiny piece over there on the ground. Yeah, not much. I know there's one there somewhere. But I gotta clean too. Friggin' mess. Oh, and I can start putting my door frames together, my door skins. I gotta get some original 1931 hinges I wanna use. But firewall's looking good. And I gotta go in. I'm so tired. It was 95 degrees today at least. Friggin' hot. Okay. Have a good night.